All right, what I'm going to do today is take all this stuff off the bench that I have here, including the miter saw, all this stuff back here too, and I'm going to lightly sand this, get all the dirt and marks off of it, because I'm going to take the recommendation of a good friend of mine, Maury, shout out to you, to go ahead and put some satin clear coats on this thing and preserve it a little better. Because this is going to get dingy. It already has in the short time I've had it. I sanded it lightly the other day just to get rid of some of it. But anyway, I'm going to sand that and give this whole thing a coat of shellac sealer coat, which is over here. Let me turn this down. Love this song. I use this stuff on my drums when I do a satin finish or gloss. It's a sealer made by Bullseye, Zinser, whatever. Been using it for years, good stuff. It's a shellac sealer that I'll put down first, probably just one coat, lightly sand it, and then put five coats of the satin urethane I used yesterday on that. And but first I gotta trim this out, so I've got a couple pieces I need to put down there. And then I've got some trimming that I need to do over here. I had to piece these pieces. It kind of aggravates me, but I didn't have any more plywood left over, and I did want to make use of what I had. So anyway, I just pieced these in. Not a big deal, really. Serving its function, which will be to hold things that I don't have a better place to put. As well as, you know, when I'm cutting a piece of wood, you know, obviously that'll lay across here. But anyway, functionality is the name of the game here. So, but yeah, this will be coated. Next time I shoot any video, this will be have five coats of urethane on it. So, all right, here we go. All right, I've been working on this for several hours now. Had a little complication. The fact that I hit a screw with this bit, I think I mentioned that yesterday. So, and I also counted the number of dowels, the Miller dowels that I had. And I didn't quite have enough to do all of the trim there and everything. So I went to the normal place I go for my supplies and who used to sell these Miller dowels, both in that size and this size right here, mainly to get another bit, but I was just gonna get another little bag of those dowels so I could use all the same color, but they don't sell them anymore. So I had to sharpen that as best as I could, but pre-drill with a smaller bit because the portion that was toasted on this one was the narrower, obviously the narrower end. So anyhow, so what I did is I combined all of my dowels that I had, both birch and walnut, and I removed the screws out of the top and put these walnut dowels in. A little bit more contrast than what I want, but that's fine. It'll look good, better than the screws for sure. So, and I believe these were the birch ones, even though they look kind of dark. I think those were birch, but they almost as dark as the walnut, really. So yeah, so I cut these pieces, put the chamfer on it, and then of course the walnut dowels across there, and then I picked up on the birch dowels down here and got those all in. Came over here, used the rest of all of my dowels except for I think one. I've got one left. So these are birch dowels. I haven't trimmed them off yet with my, this is a flush trim saw, flexible. Anyway, flush trim. I'll flush trim those here in a moment, but trim the edge of this piece of plywood here and the 2x4 here, just, you know, piece that in there a little bit better than it was. Anyhow, This whole thing right here, though, is an opening that I have because I have a step ladder that I put in there, and that enables me to get closer to this wood rack and get pieces down. So, not a big deal as far as how that's going to look. But the main thing is that this saw remains flush here when the board is laying across there. So this is kind of my catch-all area. You know, for things that I need to use, but want to have them handy, just want them out of the way at the same time. So the lathe thing, most importantly, that tailstock. So I'll put finished top coats on this too, just because I'm doing it over here, just so there's uniformity. And of course, I'll have to take this miter saw or have Coleman help me with it so I don't hurt my back. But I have to remove that and sand everything, you know, take everything off the bench and sand everything, and be ready to start seal coating and then top coating. All right, see you soon. Okay, this is done now. I made an executive decision to only do this bench portion, since that's where I'll be doing most of my work. That's the high wear surface. And I guess the other reason is because this area over here is really more utility. The plywood is pieced in because I was using leftover pieces just to make use of it. And because I already have this thing, you know, the hole there where the wires are all going through, and the fact that this isn't even all trimmed out and I'm not really worried about it, I just decided that only that which is trimmed out will get clear coated. And even though I've got a trim piece there and I had one there, I did go ahead and clear coat those. But this is... two coats of the shellac sealer and five coats of the General Finishes urethane, high performance urethane satin. So it's got a nice look to it. It's got a nice sheen too. I think you can see that. So I think I mentioned already that I had to use a combination of birch wooden dowels and walnut, because that's what I had, and I was not able to get any locally because the place that I used to buy them doesn't sell them anymore. So that's okay. It really doesn't look all that bad anyway, to have, you know, the different, good, like that middle shelf right there has the black walnut, the one on the bottom is the birch. So it's a really just an issue of functionality anyhow. And before, I had just screws up here in the tabletop, so this looks better anyway. So yeah, so that's all done, and step back so you can see it. So that's gonna come in real handy. That's probably where I'll do most of my work, assembling drums, working on boxes, which I plan on making, keepsake boxes and things like that. I got a myriad of ideas right now going on, one of which is to also purchase, probably going to wait till June though, because I'm expecting a refund from something, and to invest in a CNC router. Why am I pointing right here? Because this is where I'm going to build a bench for the CNC router. And so more to come on that, but that will it'll complete my shop. So everything is really come together nicely. There are a couple or three little things that I still need and want to do, but this is really turning out as well or better than I even anticipated. So I'm really excited about it and hope to be getting some drum orders here before too long. I have to get back to work on my website, but anyway, there it is, all done. What do you think, Maury?
All right, catch you guys later.